Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Independent Broadcast Network. I'm Winners at the One. We've got Dr. Killinger here and Robo's here too, and we are about to cover Friday night hockey. It is Friday night, and it is time for hockey. And we've got a pretty interesting lineup, very eclectic tonight, guys. It's going to be, first, we've got the Shithawks in an epic show match against Kill Squad coming at you live, the new hot team that everybody's talking about. So that's going to be happening. And then it's, who is it? Kim Jong Il's playing the look chaser? Or it's just Kim? It's
Kim.
Kim, yeah.
Kim.
But
okay. All right. It's not anybody from North Korea that might be running the country here.
Kim.
So, might be North Korea.
It's not Little Kim, yes. Yeah. Okay. Oh, I'm sad that's not Little Kim. But either way, it will be an entertaining game nonetheless. And then after that, we're going to take a look at the new version of hockey that came out. Cryptic Sea has put out an all new alpha of the new. It's an alpha. It's like the kids are doing with the zombies and stuff these days. But this doesn't have zombies, but it does have a vending machine. And we will be, and it is evil, and we will be looking at that tonight. We'll be looking in the face of evil in the guise of a cheesesteak vending machine.
Yeah.
You don't fuck with that vending machine.
Oh, my God. It's scary. It's scary, man. But, yeah, so as you can tell, we've got a big lineup tonight. And this is just part of a huge, guys, eSport weekend that's happening all weekend long here on the Independent Broadcast Network. Now, Sunday night, this is a big fucking event. The greatest night in eSports history, too, is coming up as Texas, my home state, takes on Massachusetts, Hollow's home state.
And if you bring in a can of soup, you get a free can of soup.
Yes, and it will be bobbleheads given out, depending on what state you are cheering for. So it's going to be a great night of esports. All the all-star players from Texas are taking on all the all-star players from Massachusetts, and we will have guest stars and pro player commentary from members of both states. So it's going to be a lot of fun, and we are really looking forward to that one, guys. But this one tonight is going to be pretty fun. What about Kill Squad coming at you live?
It's going to be an epic matchup whenever you Kill Squad, on the ice. I've played them absolutely no times in my life, but still they'd be an absolutely amazing rival.
Well, you're familiar with the players on the team, of course.
Oh. I absolutely am.
We're looking at an open skate right now.
Yeah, this is just playing around. But in a mere minute or so, we will have the real deal.
Oh, not that these players on the ice are not the real deal.
I most definitely am not the real deal.
Sure you are, man.
I'm actually fake Robo.
You've got one assist in this game. It says right there on the on the scoreboard.
For once,
and on the lone goal that the red team has scored in this game, I might add, with 30 seconds left, it's looking pretty good for this blue team right now, and they've got the puck here at center ice, and they're just playing around with it now. It's like a cat playing with a toy. They're just keeping it away from this red team, now trying to break through. Oh, again, taken off the blade, and a chance, open net, just wide, 15 seconds left. It looks like it's going to probably end up that way, and now we are about to go into this big Shithawks Kill Squad game.
Look at that amazing shot by Not Robo.
And it goes back the other way, and that's going to do it. And the players leap in the air in celebration and then fall and flop around a lot. If you really want to see some flopping around, wait till we start playing the new hockey and trying to regain our feet when the vending machine hits us.
So not only can the vending machine wreck you, it then charges you money for wrecking you with the Philly cheesesteaks.
Yeah, I was telling the guys earlier, it's probably best not to trust any sort of sandwich you might get from a vending machine. That's one of those.
I'd still eat it.
Life story tips, pro tip. So it looks like the players are taking the ice now as we look at our lineups here.
And we got an amazing matchup right here. The KS rolling out deep right now. We got KS Auto on the ice.
Ooh, with two KSs for a double dose of his pimp.
Yeah, Kill Squad is blue, and the Shayhawks are red.
Dick McButts takes it around his nets, passes it up the ice, it looks like maybe. Stopped by double KS Auto. Held back into the red zone behind the goal line. Dick McButts takes it up the ice. Red looks like they're going with no goalies. He takes a nice shot, goes wide of net on Slurs. Slurs playing goalie. He absolutely sucks at it. Screw you, Slurs. I'm not biased at all.
Not at all. Not at all. But at least you can see the name. For some reason, I'm not seeing the names on my minimap. I don't know what I've done to this thing.
Well, you've obviously got to refuculate it.
Yeah, no, just like the Trailer Park Boys, yes.
Thank you. Someone knows the reference.
Yeah, they are coming back with a new season. And here's a shot across the bow of the blue net that does not go in. And it is still the Shithawks in front here. And Kill Squad taking their time. And now they will start pushing this the other way. And he's got it there at the blue line. He's got a lot of people on him, a couple of players there. It's going to be backhanded back, and they're going to take some time to play it here at center ice once again. Now back at the blue line. Here they go. This could be a chance. Again, the Shithawks playing with nobody in the net. We saw them do this before.
Yeah, and it didn't work then. I'm wondering if it's going to work now. Somehow I doubt it.
Well, it looks like they actually have two defenders back, so if they're doing that, they may have a chance with two defenders, two forwards. It's just like 4-on-4 hockey.
Yeah, but there's one that almost goes in right off the post there on the left side. And
the post
so
is literally
now...
Hitler now.
Oh. Yeah, like the that thread on Reddit. Here's
oh, look at
that's
this.
That's why you want a goalie. And that's why you want a goalie.
Puts the first one on the board for Kill Squad coming at you live with an assist from Big V. And they just tag teamed up and got one in there. That was very nice.
Kill
and here's
Squad
another chance.
Face-off. And oof.
Another reason you want a goalie is those quick early goals.
Especially if it's from Otto.
When, the defensemen don't quite have time to get far back enough.
Yeah, he's got that quick release. And now again, they have got it back in the Shithawk zone, and some pursuit behind the net here that will carry it back around, and it looks like we're destined for another collision along the boards, and again, it is the Shithawks coming up with it, and they will manage to get it out of the zone. Nope, held in. Nope, battle for it here, and they're going to get around, and this one is flipped
on
at
net.
The net, and is a save made. It's going to direct it all the way back to the middle of the rink.
And look at this. We got a nice offensive opportunity from Otto. Takes a shot. He makes it. Look at that. Two goals for Otto tonight. 2-0 for Kill Squad tonight.
Only 3 minutes into the game.
Just lifted it straight at him. And
Kill Squad
wins
the face-off.
KS Otto again.
What a player. Look at this. Nice shot on that. Blocked by Fleurs. What a save. The Shithawks moving it out of the blue zone for some reason. We don't know why. Takes a shot and
set it back up from distance. And he got another save. We're
standing tall.
And look at this. Nice opportunity by Notled, and he fails at it.
Yeah, Tellur's being very proactive with the puck there and pushing it out as he facing a lot of pressure coming in. So, yeah, it's still 2-0, and Kill Squad making a very convincing first period so far. A couple of goals up with a minute to play.
Very defensive, it looks like the Kill Squad is. They keep, shooting it back down towards the other end there. Sorry, I'm at a loss for words at how shitty they're playing.
Well, the Shithawks have had their struggles over the past HQML season, but they definitely have some great players. But
look at that, a hat trick by Otto.
And that was
he scored
three different goals three different ways already here in this first period. And so he is putting on a clinic again tonight. We have called his name many times in the past year on Friday Night Hockey. And again, this is a solid lineup. We talked about the solid lineup for the Shithawks. These are definitely some heavy hitters on this Kill Squad team as well. And so they're really showing us that as we go to 30 seconds left. Shithawks trying to make a run with it, though. And they are going to have a chance at it here. Probably going to try to set something up in front. No, carrying it around. Shot goes off the side of the net. The rebound.
Look at that.
Time attempt. Dick McButts with help from Iskin. And they are on the board. The Shithawks have scored to make it 3-1.
What an amazing goal that was. One timer. Beautiful deflection right into the net.
Yes, very nicely played. And those are two talented players right there. And that was just a nice tandem in front. So that's going to take us to the second period, though. It's 3-1, and Kill Squad doing a pretty good job there. KS Auto with three goals, but that last one there by the Shithawks, that has to give them a little bit extra jump going into these final two periods.
Indeed.
Might I mention Big V with two assists on two of those auto goals.
Yeah, Big V is quite a shooter himself. And
look at this.
See that. There's one.
And it goes in.
Dick Van Dyke.
With the wrister, a beautiful shot there, right at right around waist level, a little higher, and very deadly to a goalie. And there's one.
Oh, my goodness.
It is saved. And that's Talure's there in the net. Yes, he's doing pretty good there.
A nice pass to, it looks like, Goose. Goose shoots, he scores, cooks the net.
Oh, man. And just like that, a couple of goals from both sides. 4-2 now. And Kill Squad, every time the Shithawks have rung the bell, they have answered it so far. So with 30 seconds into the second period, already a lot of action on the puck going both ways here.
Very physical match, too. I mean, there's been a lot of collisions mid-center ice.
Yeah, well, we knew that these teams, it's personal, so it's going to be a little chippy at times, and that makes it more fun. That's why we're presenting these teams for the show match tonight. Now, HQML Season 3 was supposed to start tonight, I think, but with the format change, they were going to go with King of the Hill, but people were like, let's just play it regular. Here's a shot regularly would go in. But just off the side of the post there. But, yeah, we will be starting Season 3 of HQML next week here on IBN2 around the same time on this same channel. And we'll have the schedule and lineups here in the next week on all that. And that'll be
beautiful
on the hockey subreddit.
The offensive zone there.
Yes, indeed. And still they are pushing in. Here come the Shithawks. They're bringing two, now three. Tried to hold on to it at the point there. Gets away from him. Now a possible breakaway chance. Getting loose with it. Nobody in the net. Time to shoot. He shoots and scores.
Otto with his fourth goal tonight.
KS Otto with his fourth. And Goose on the assist. And again, this Kill Squad team. And just too much KS Otto for the Shithawks to hold down right now.
So, expert analysis, do you think the goalie situation that they're having on the Shithawks is working?
I think you look at the score and you have to say no.
The empirical evidence would have to point to no, yes.
You just used an oxymoron, no and yes.
Well, it's, I don't know, they're playing up pretty high right there, and now dropping back into a little bit more defense as they chase the puck around here and try to get it out of the zone. Yeah, we've seen that the goalie has become very, very important here in HQML and the North American game. There was a time when you could afford not to have one, but the goalies have really been that's a position that has really evolved a lot in North America, I think, over the past few months.
Oh, yes. Easily. I mean, it's one of the easiest to see how it's evolved. I mean, just watch the videos every week on our YouTube channel. And every week, the saves get a little better and a little better.
Oh, yeah. And there's a block defensively there. Shithawks pushing in, and it is going to be taken away from them, though. Now they are on their heels as here comes
toss it up in the air.
On the break. They break him up there, and they're going to battle for it. There's, again, some bodies being thrown around at the blue line. And now
look at this breakaway opportunity. Stopped by the goalie. Dick.
Nope.
Dick takes a shot. He scores.
Dick from McButts. Downtown, Dick McButts.
Man.
Second, Iskin again collaborating on that one. And it is 5-3, and the Shithawks are hanging with them. I mean, it's not going to be a romp by any means for either of these teams.
It's still
going
a game.
To be a hard-fought game.
What an amazing second period it's been with only about a minute left to go. Sorry, a minute 10 now.
They're a nice stop in front of the Shithawks. The rebound attempt, almost dangerous. That trickles across the crease there over to the left side and into the far faceoff circle. And now it will be cleared back the other way. And again, coming out big to play this, could pay for it. It does. Iskin gets a solo goal there. Credit for that one, as it is 5-4 now, and the Shithawks have pulled within one as we go into the end of the second period. It is a lot closer than it started.
Oh, yeah.
It is a whole one goal closer than what it started, I think.
Yes, if my math is correct, that is closer. Yes.
Everyone is now using hashtag comeback. Can the Shithawks make a comeback?
They very well could, but it's not going to. They're not going to make it easy for them because Kill Squad coming at your life is still scoring quite a few goals themselves. So 15 seconds left, and we'll see how this one turns out. It makes for an exciting third period either way. And here come the Shithawks. It is dumped in, 5 seconds left. Probably not going to have time to do much with that one. And, yes, time will expire, and we'll go to the third period with the scoreline the same. The Kill Squad 5 and the Shithawks 4.
I mean, the impression I got there in the second period is that a lot of the individuals in the Shithawks really stepped up. I saw a lot of really good individual talent, a lot of great stick handling. But that, still, I mean, the Kill Squad's working better as a team, so that's why they're still in the lead. We'll see what happens here.
Can the Kill Squad stay together as looks like Milan Lucic and Dial battle for it in the corner? Dick Van Dijk of the Shithawks takes a shot on net.
Oh,
scores! Look at that.
And we're tied. We've got a game.
Dick Van Dijk with his second. Iskin with his third assist. And we are tied at 5. And, yes, this is – so, yeah, hashtag comeback, perhaps. Mm-hmm. Yes, the Shithawks are definitely showing signs of life when they need to right now in this third period. That's a very timely goal. So here we go. It's at center ice, and they are converging on it. Three of the Shithawks do get at it, and they're loose on a two-on-one break now. It's across the net. Just a little bit behind him.
Yeah.
If this was IRL hockey, I'm sure they would have scored.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. But
Big Butts takes it around the corner, is met by Big V. Look at this opportunity in the middle, broken up by Dial, it looks like. Iskin takes it around the back of the net, right around Slurs. Tries to pass it up towards the boards, handled by Notler.
Oh, another attempt here. Oh,
look at that beautiful hat trick.
With the hat trick, yeah.
Wow. Dick McButts.
It's almost like they planned it that way.
Yes, what a game. So now with 3:40 left, the Shithawks take their first lead, and it is very close as it can be without being tied.
Indeed.
They went from 3-1 to 6-5 with 3:30 left in the third period as Dick McButts passes up to Dick Van Dijk, who is met by Big V, taking it back towards the red goal, shoots and whiffs on it. I'm the whiff master here, not you.
Yes, the sudden tumescence of the Dicks is resulting in some high-powered offense here in the closing moments of this game, and now they're going to get it out of their zone. Maybe. Well, they're taking their time in doing so, waiting on the setup downtown here, which they will follow in as it's dumped around the corner here. And the battle for it behind the net. They're going to be able to set up in front again. He's going to flip it back the other way. And now here they will try to intercept this and hold it in at the blue line.
Whoa. Oncoming force. What a nice defensive play there.
Oh, man. Kill Squad were coming at their life there and converging
indeed,
on
yes.
the puck. So, yeah, that still 2 minutes and 25 seconds left to play in this one. And Kill Squad will step up the urgency here as they need to get a goal to tie before this is all said and done. And there's one flipped way out, wristed to center ice, and the Shithawks are going to pick this off. And it's dribbling around in the back there. Again, he's carried around. Here's a just across and not quite in. So still held in, and he went right. It went five hole on him. So they're going to regather it here at center ice again with a minute and 48 seconds.
Oh, no.
Look at that. Four on an empty net.
Big V.
All the way from downtown. First of the game, and that's going to tie things up at six. We are knotted once again with 1:43 left. And, wow, what a great goal.
The next one could very well be it right here.
Okay, are we asking again whether they are – well served by not having a goaltender in the net?
It very well could be. I mean,
his
like
work's
I was
better
saying earlier.
The last period and a half. Yeah, I will admit.
Yeah, I like that it gets them to play a more up-tempo style and a very aggressive defense in front of just around the very top of the slot. But
what a save!
yes.
And look at this, a breakaway opportunity by not laying. Will he shoot? He gets defended.
He gets defended, indeed. Yes.
Great demonstration of that, yes. So now here they are. The Shithawks are going to circle with this one. And trying to set up. Nope. Loose shot. Wide to the right. Under a minute left to go. Still tied here. Battles along the boards. Bodies flying. People are smacking each other around a little bit here. And now the Shithawks will take their time and use the boards to get this down. 36 seconds left. Not much time left in regulation.
Here.
Yes. So we don't want to jinx it by saying one way or the other, but it very well could. As we go under 30 seconds here, Shithawks trying to get the game winner. Kill Squad as well. They've got it down in the Shithawk zone. Chance now. Shot again. Wide right. Rebound in front. Possibly. No. Just right along the red line there. And held in. 12 seconds left. Will they have time? Shithawks do carry it out.
One last breakaway opportunity.
Chance. Is he going to get to it? No. It is taken. And a nice save from distance.
Will it go in?
Not enough time.
Saved.
And we are going to overtime in our first game of the night. Unsurprising. A place we have been many times on Friday Night Hockey, guys. And these two teams have really put on a show so far. Mm-hmm. Great performances from both Kill Squad and the Shithawks. It almost sucks that there has to be a winner and loser of this one. I think the winners are us because we are watching.
I think, if this is representative of some of the best play in HQML, it's going to be a good season. Going to be a good season.
What a close goal there. Does the Shithawks really want to go with a no-goalie strategy in overtime, though?
I don't know. That's a bit risky.
Look at all these long clearing attempts that the goalies are doing.
I love it. They're shooting it right past my camera, and I get these lovely close-ups of the puck flying by.
Yeah, it's coming to you in high definition from the Roy Alchies Arena in Chicago, Illinois, on the fastest internet backbone in the world. And these Killinger bringing these fine footage and A Real, B Real, it's all real here on the IBN to the deuce. As we, I'm really excited about Texas versus Massachusetts.
Oh, it's going to be good.
So much esports.
Definitely a good game right there.
I invoke the cliche on the subreddit of, we'll sell you the entire seat,
but
you
only
need the edge.
The edge.
Indeed. Because it's true. It's going to be at least as exciting as
look
this.
Look at this. Milan Lucic and Chaos Auto working together, getting a goal.
Oh,
look at that.
Never mind.
3:30 left in the first period of overtime. Goose taking it behind his net. Iskin coming up to challenge Goose, it looks like. Towards Milan Lucic, where the Shithawks come and intercept it and send it up to Iskin.
Tim Barrett evidently has a Dogecoin bet on this game.
Oh, and now they got Kanye coins.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's going to be a new thing.
Some Kanye?
Yeah, Kanye.
There you go.
I'm looking forward to the Kanye currency.
Attempt on net right here. Nope. Broken up by Shithawks. Or Kill Squad, I should say.
Yes, Kill Squad in blue trying to get this out of their zone. Shithawks still holding it in, and they're just very patient with the puck here and trying to set up some passing lanes. And this one is going to be shot wide into the corner, and it will be played out. Yeah. Again, that open net.
Oh, goalie goal to end the game. Slurs one goal.
With the capper. The Kill Squad
and
coming
GG,
at you live
indeed.
From between the pipes at KS Auto with a great game. Gets the assist on that game winner in overtime. And a goalie goal, the best of all goals, I've always said, as a goalie. So what a great way to end this show match. And now
this is really
Team
fantastic.
Kim, representing North Korea, Team Kim is going to be playing against the Luck Chasers.
What an amazing match we're going to have here as well.
Yes, indeed. I'm interested to see what happens with this Kim team. It looks like they've got some good players. Yeah, there's Pet the Kim, who I'm assuming is Pet the Pizza. And he's representing in red for the communist colors of North Korea. And he's joined by Marchie and Taser here as well. I'm going to be banned from R Pyongyang if I keep it up. Anyway, here are the Luck Chasers, too, in blue, man.
Everyone is eventually banned from R Pyongyang.
R Pyongyang, yes.
And everyone is eventually made a moderator of R Pyongyang. It's just a cycle.
The cycle of life in Pyongyang.
Yeah, life finds a way.
Here we go with an amazing matchup here between Chem and Luck Chasers.
Yeah, you guys want to give me the lineups here?
All right, in blue for the Luck Chasers, we have Ticklebox, PK Paching, Ace Bolf, and Andy T300. Ford,
and
there you go. Go for it.
The Chem, we have Taser, Marchie, Pet the Chem, and Tim Barrett.
Oh, indeed. So it's Chem?
Chem or Chem or Kim. We've been doing... because Chem sounds kind of sort of...
truly outrageous.
When you slur it a little bit like people who live in Texas do, evidently, it kind of sounds like Kim.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, it's like that's what I thought was like Leader Kim. Either way, they are representing in glorious red here as the Luck Chasers. You know and love the Luck Chasers from this last season on Friday Night Hockey HQML.
Indeed.
They will be back for season 3, so it is good to see them tonight in action. And this Team Kim got some heavy hitters on their team as well. I mean, you can't count out a team with Tim Barrett. So we are a minute in, and they are showing mercy on both sides as there are no goals scored yet. But I expect this one to be a pretty high-flying affair, guys.
And the only reason why there's been no goals as of right now is because the puck has not crossed the goal line in one of either two teams' nets.
That's true. And I think it's going to be the team that does that the most that ends up prevailing.
That's usually what happens.
The statistics would agree, yes.
Oh, my God.
I will I will also note that...
I don't even know what sarcasm anymore. I don't.
Oh, there we go. That's blocked. All right. PK Paching.
My sarcasm machine just exploded.
So, I would like to remind everybody that we are going to be looking at the new prototype of Hockey Question Mark.
Yes.
After this game, actually.
You mean the Shakespeare version of it?
Yes, the Robo Shakespeare versus the Cheesesteak Vending Machine. The Electric Boogaloo, whatever.
Now, when you put it that way, it sounds like one of those sci-fi channel movies. You know, like the
Crocosaurus,
you know, versus the giant whatever.
And there's nothing
wrong with that. I know where this is going.
Again, nothing wrong with that.
Big collision at center ice as Pet the Chem and Ticklebox collide at each other. Tim Barrett takes the puck up through the center ice into the offensive zone. Gets a little tripped up there by Ace Bluff. Tries to take
Ace Bluff.
They're going to just kind of mob around it here.
Yeah, he was bluffing there, obviously. So, but now he's for reals as this one is still held in. And the Luck Chasers are trying to get some defensive blades on this puck, but not able to do it. There's one. And now it's bounced out, and they've got a chance possibly to take this the other way. Nope, another big collision here. And a little bit of a Wesley Willis headbutt there at the end. And now they're going to try to push this the other direction. No, it is blocked and held in. Here comes Chim or Kim. As they do get it going one way, possibly. Nope, now back the other. As here come the Luck Chasers. And this one goes beyond the goalie here. 1:41 left and still no score. And neither team just really generating a lot of heat offensively just yet, as the both defenses really on their toes here and really anticipating everything that they're trying to do on offense.
And, yeah, this is almost the opposite of last game, where it was really high scoring, and now we've gone almost the entire first period. Nothing.
There is also a goalie on both teams.
That's true. That is true, yes.
Oh, yes, that might be tipping the scales in that favor, yes. But either way, it's still, as we go under 1 minute left in the first period, both of these teams searching for their first point of the game and just kind of feeling each other out. You can kind of see the kind of a little bit more tentative on the offense. Nobody really wants to make any crucial errors that lead to turnovers. And so now it is still held in the Kim zone, and leader Kim will take it out and, get it past Dennis Rodman and everybody.
Oh, that is
what a save.
Nice play there to make the save, yes. Who's that in the net?
P.K. Pachang.
It's P.K. Pachang. And now he will make a much easier save, but sometimes those are very deceptive as well. Carrying this one into the corner and across.
Puts it in front of his own net.
He was fortunate that all the other team was in the distance there.
It was a strategy to confuse him, obviously.
There's a shot attempt that is going to go far from the net, as we will cap off this first period and go to the second with no score between these two teams in our nightcap game, our second game of Friday Night Hockey tonight. Don't forget, HQML Season 3 will start next week. You will see these teams and many more as the best and brightest in North America take to the stage here at the Royale with Cheese Arena in beautiful Chicago, Illinois. And every Friday night that will be happening as Season 3 of HQML gets underway. We want you to definitely make time to join us there.
Oh, look at that. Score.
Tickle box. Gets the first one on the board for the Luck Chasers. A nice wrister there to put his team up 1-0. And Luck Chasers, again, showing a lot of that skill that they showed in the last season of Friday Night Hockey. Now they've got another chance again. This is a little bit wide. It's going to go just across to the right there, now picked up and held in. And now Kim is going to try to get it out. And whether it's Lil' Kim or whatever your favorite Kim might be, Gail Kim. I love Gail Kim. I should have retweeted Gail Kim tonight. One of the greatest wrestlers in the world.
Live and learn.
Well, I wanted to make sure that Ashley Banfield from CNN knew about this. Because
yeah, that's
so much CNN,
esports. Yeah.
Now, I've always loved her. I think it's the glasses. You know, she always had that. You know, I love Ashley Banfield.
A little bit of the librarian thing going on, yeah.
Yeah, she's awesome. And they had her out there in the cold today, as there's a big cold front coming across the United States. Even here in Texas, man, they're saying down to like 10 degrees and stuff, which is not much by world standards, but by Texas standards, people are like stocking up. And, you know, it's like the end of the world or some shit.
I actually used to live in Northern Canada, and the coldest I've ever been in is probably like minus 56. With the wind chill here next week, we're probably going to get down about minus 45.
Yeah, the worst I ever did was Chicago, I guess, where it was like 25 below with a 80 below wind chill or something ridiculous like that. After that, I said I would never complain about the cold again. Here's a shot that is just behind the net, and they will both try to get this one out and dig for it at center ice. Now coming the other way, though, with it, as Kim is going to go ahead and take it around. and set up and use the boards here to work to their advantage. The boards, when played properly, are just like having another player on your team. And that's as true in regular hockey as well as it is here on Hockey Question Mark. And this is Cryptic Seas Hockey Question Mark. You can get it at hockeyquestionmark.com. Be sure and sign up for the alpha of the new version. It's like $8, and that's a small price to pay for, I thought, Kellinger, for all the fun that we've had with this game. I think a lot of people felt the same way. You know,
for an amazing amount of fun and a vending machine.
Yes, yes, indeed. And as he said, it's still in the early stages, so this mm-hmm. was for, as he said, true believers only, and we'll give you a look at it here coming up. But, oh, there's a nice deflection, and now they're going to pick this up, Luck Chasers, with it back in the zone of Kim, and now they are going to have to try to get it out. 2 minutes left to play in the second. Again, the Luck Chasers up by one, the only goal of the game so far. Very low scoring affair.
They just put in sweaty goals.
Uh-oh.
I know who's going to lose now.
Oh, what a save! Redirected into the corner. Very beautiful. And here it is in around the net. And sent out as we go to 1:30 left. This will be played out of the net by the goalies. Going to circle around with this.
Tim Barrett's actually playing in net right now. Kind of an interesting strategy since Tim kind of sucks in net.
Well, Cryptic C is in the chat right now, and he says his Twitch doesn't seem to be really working for him, but he'd be happy to answer any questions about the new version. If I guess us or anybody here watching has any, can type them in the chat.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, so, definitely put your questions in. I know that a lot of people were... Yeah, it's still in the early stages, but I know that the new physics of the game... Oh, yeah, we're asked about goalie mode. Yeah, that's mm-hmm. that's an interesting one.
As a goalie myself,
yeah,
that's, I have
actually,
to
yeah.
that.
When will goalie mode be available? Which is first I've heard of goalie mode, but then again, maybe I'm not paying attention. Must not
yeah, because the way I understand it, the new model of the whole player, it's meant to function as a real, like, hands and arms, as opposed to just being kind of a static model like it was before, that headbutts and stuff. So it gives them a little bit more flexibility as far as how the mechanisms of shooting and skating work. But that should translate, I'm hoping, into some more evolved goalie play. And if these guys are this good, just with the tools that they have right now as goalies, just think of if they could use their whole body and, like, dive and make real saves on stuff.
As the second period ends, score still 1-0 for the Luck Chasers. Sorry, I had to give an update on the game.
yeah, we do have a game going on here. As we will go to the third period with the scoreline still the same here. This is, I expected a few more goals, actually, from these teams, but more of a defensive affair here in our second game tonight on Friday Night Hockey. And still time for both these teams for an offensive explosion. There's one that's just swept away. I don't even know if he actually got a stick on that. He just kind of shooed it out of the net. And now it will go in the other direction. And again, here comes some pressure from the Luck Chasers. And just he's chased that one a little far from the stick. And now going back the other way is Kim. They've got it. Here's a shot. And it's high and wide. And they will pursue this now. And is taken away, though, by the Luck Chasers. And they're going to have to follow this back into their own end. And that'll burn off about a minute of this third period with us. A little bit of action on both ends now. And here come this Kim team. Leader Kim, Lil Kim, either Kim. And back in their own zone, though.
It looks
and
like
they have
Kim is actually going without a goalie now.
Yeah.
Until Tim Barrett came in net.
Yeah, Kim Barrett.
Until you said something.
Yeah. Here's the shot.
Oh, look at that.
Ace Wolf.
With a low swinger there, and Andy T300, the Terminator, gets the assist. So 2-0, the Luck Chasers get another one on the board, and that is another one to their total. So if my math is correct, That are two goals, if I count them correctly. Yes, 327 left to play. Here's one trickling in. Does this have a chance? Oh,
just
not
just wide
quite.
Of net.
I remind you that if you type your questions into chat, in the Twitch chat.
In the Twitch chat, not in here.
Not in the game
not
chat.
Not in the game here.
Yeah. I didn't specify that very clearly the first time. And if you type them into the Twitch chat, Cryptic C might very well answer them.
Yeah, you got to watch the channel, man. It's the least
watching
you can
the channels
do,
where it's
yeah.
all at.
Yes, to all the millions that are watching right now on Twitch TV, I want to thank you for and remind you that Sunday, it is Texas versus Massachusetts, the greatest night in esports history, part two. And again, don't forget, looming in the
distance. Look at this opportunity here.
USA versus Canada 2 coming up as well.
Vote Robo as defense or goalie.
Here you go, Robo. I don't know if you can... I'll read this out loud just in case. For now, the goalie will just be the same as players, but the puck does collide with players now. So the goalie will just evolve. It'll start as a player and then evolve based on feedback.
It's going to be the wall of Robo, it looks like.
There you go. So,
but yeah, because like we were saying, just being able to use the whole body to make stops is a big, big improvement over what the goalies are working with now. I mean, that's a big step forward, I think, for the way the game is played.
Very easily. There's a lot of shots I could have stopped, you know, if... it collided with my body, and now it actually can. So look at that amazing shot right there that did not collide with his body.
And, Cryptic C also says that since the models are more human-like, it'll be easier to add things such as butterfly moves.
Oh, yes, that's true.
And that, Tellurs asks if there are plans for left-handed shooters. And Cryptic C says that, yes, they'll be doing left-handed shooters soon.
Yeah, because, you know, I actually play left-handed, even though I'm right-handed, because I played goal, you know, and you hold your stick that way and you make shots that way anyway. So I found when I skated as forward, I needed that left-handed stick to play properly.
See, I'm just the opposite of you. I mean, look at that amazing goal by Sweaty Goals.
Sweaty Goals.
All-time leader in scoring in a single game here on Friday Night Hockey, Sweaty Goals, the secret weapon. He gets one, and here's one that is deflected off way into space. And back down. Not into the net, though.
Not
almost
quite.
The net.
Yes.
That moon
almost had a USA
Canada
moment.
Back to what I was saying, though, as a goalie, yes, you do hold the stick with your left hand, but I, as a player, though, I just have to hold it with my right hand.
Yeah, but it's something that makes a big difference to a lot of the players of the game, of the hockey question mark game, too. So, there it is. Confirmation to the hardcore community that, yes, for Cryptic C said so.
Look at that goal by Tim Barrett and Tim Kaukonen wrecked the goalie.
Oh, man. With less than 30 seconds left on the clock, we have another tie game. And
hold on.
Hold on to your breath, everyone.
We got 15 seconds to change that. Let's see what happens here.
Oh, man. As now they are trying to keep it out of the clutches of the luck chase.
There's a shot.
Left. Possible attempt of staying with him man on man. Very nice
overtime.
Defense. Just sticking with him tightly, playing the body, and keeping him from getting a shot off in time. We will go to overtime once again. Oh, man.
What an amazing matchup this is. Tied 2-2, and we got one whole period to play before someone scores.
Man.
Maybe more.
Somebody asked about will there be a pause feature? It's not planned at the moment.
Yeah, with multiplayer, that's understandable.
I think my internet is glitching up right now. It says Ace Bluff has 29 goals.
I don't think that's correct.
It also says Andy T300 has 15 assists.
Yeah, I'm not seeing that. That's
Yeah, on mine, he's just got the one.
Cryptic C also confirmed that the models, as you'll see here soon in 0.59, are a work in progress. So anyone who
Shakespeare. Oh, what
an amazing save by PK Paching.
Nice. But the rebound, oh, again. And this one is going to be deflected into the corner. Now, again, across the shot, the slot there, fired across the bow as a lot of pucks flying in front of the net here. PK Pachin so far getting the better of them as we are a minute into this overtime session as our second game of the night, again, went to overtime, and both these teams stepping it up. Here's Chance in front. It looked like they just won too many passes. Tic-tac, and that's going to carry it behind the net. Now looking for the wraparound attempt, deflected out, chased in. Luck Chasers are chasing the puck, as is their name best befits them, as this Kim team, relentless in front of the net, trying for another wraparound attempt. It is going to be carried out beyond the blue line and sent back in. PK Pachin will hold on to this for a minute and pass it back. Uh-oh. And they're still holding it in. Look at the job they're doing to put the offensive pressure on.
Absolutely.
This is
going
to be a team to watch in HQML Season 3 if they play with that kind of intensity. But now here comes Luck Chasers the other way. He's going to come out big to try to play his big save out near the dot. Quite a play there, as very proactive indeed, as both goalies have been really pushing the envelope on just making the whole side of the rink their crease, as needs to be. That's one good thing. The shooting has evolved in the game, so it'll be good to match with having better goalie coverage, because some of these guys could put it pretty much wherever they want to at will. Just get it past the blue line and just fling it right at the corners. So it will be good to see how that evolves along with the saving abilities of the new goalies.
Look at this, an opportunity, and denied.
Boom. It's the caster curse. Casters giveth and casters taketh away. Sir, and here's an opera. Never mind.
Taketh away there. And this Kim team in numbers now got a block there. And
breakaway incoming.
The
here
break
it comes.
Chance.
And he scores. Sweaty goals with his 16th goal. Pet the Kim with 11 assists.
Pet the Kim gets his second. Yes. And that is the game winner. Again, sweaty goals leading the way for his team. And wow, what a finish from this new team. Kim or Chim or however you want to pronounce it. Either way, put it in stone. It's a win here on Friday Night Hockey.
Hey, how about that .059?
Yep. We're going to give it a look-see. And I'm very excited about doing so. Here we go. And it was going to be Royale with Cheese 2, the quickening, and then Killinger made it Royale with Cheese 2, the quickening of the electric boogaloo, and somehow it turned into the quickening of the L. It's some sort of Cyrillic. So, but just garbled enough to confuse any of the Russian players of the game. So.
Hold on.
Okay. Well, I'm in this game right now and doing terribly at it, so.
I just got wrecked.
Here we go. Now everybody's joining. This will be fun. I think, Killinger, you set this up for 32 players.
Okay. So we'll see how many people can actually join, but I don't know. We'll see.
It's lagging pretty good, actually.
Yeah, it gets a little choppy when you get we ran into this trying to run it just as the client.
I can try and play with it a bit. I'm joining right now.
Okay.
It said we were already at 5, which I think we're
five. It'll give our viewers a chance to get a look at the new version. As you can see, there are a lot of changes coming to the game. And so, the game as we know it, done changed, as Cuddy from The Wire might say.
I'm going to go wreck that vending machine.
And I'm just sitting here. It says connecting. Connecting.
I just shot it at somebody who was breakdancing.
I think that might have been me.
Wow, that is that, those are some sick moves, dog.
We will.
Oh my!
I'm face down on the ice, just skating around.
Cryptic C says he doesn't believe more than five can join. So,
well, they didn't believe a man could fly, and then Superman proved otherwise. So, yeah. Wow. Yeah, because there are, I think, five people in the game now. Yeah, so.
All right, well, I'm going to back out for a minute.
Can you, are you in the game?
No, I was stuck at connecting. And we're going to kill the server and flip it back on. Just cheat real quick. So, sorry you guys who are playing right now.
Okay. Yeah, but yeah, it is a work in progress. And I think that the changes to the game are going to really be fun when everything gets kind of ironed out in a competitive play. I think the next step, Cryptic C was saying, was to make it team-based, where you can have a team v team. Right now, it's the only thing we've got set up on this server at the moment is a vending machine mode.
Oh, and it is laggy. Woo! All right, well, final product will not be this laggy, I assure you.
Yes, but this is just an alpha.
This is definitely just an alpha. But I rebooted the server, and by the time I rebooted the server, alt-tabbed back into hockey, there were already 3 out of 5 people joined. So
he's down. Take this,
pretty
son
quick.
Of a bitch. Vending machine.
And I'm going to press X. You can see here, this is... Oh, I just fell over that person.
Thanks.
You can see kind of what people look like. And obviously, so this is a work in progress, but... You're Robo Shakespeare. I think Winter said it best. And we're trying to stand
Bring
up. I'm back up.
I'm gonna hit it with my sword.
Oh. Hang on. Let me get it around here. It's not even moving anymore.
Nope. I'm gonna go back to the middle.
Yeah, but as you can see, we've got a full player model now. So it's a little different than before when it was just kind of the model and then the stick kind of separate from it. This is an extension of your body where you are actually controlling the stick with arms and stuff. So that's a big change to how the physics will work as far as shooting and passing.
And I don't think you can score on that net. Whoever's... gently place the puck in that net. I'm not sure that's how it works. But try to get out of here. So now you can kind of fight each other with the sticks. There you go. I don't know who I'm sitting there molesting, but yeah, there you go.
Have a vending machine.
Oh, and you can do the whole Pavel Bure ride the stick move when you score, too.
Yeah.
The Russians will enjoy that. This game is for Russia, but it's for North America, too. That's what's been fun about it. Oh, and I'm back on my feet.
And the time's up. Yeah, we all reset right in the middle on top of each other. Just everybody pile on. Oh, and I fell over.
Oh, here goes the vending machine.
And we're attempting to stand up. And we're up, baby. Nope. No, I went on my face.
I'm actually just going to go around like a turtle right now.
Yeah, kind of like a newborn baby colt, just trying to find its feet. Yeah, I found
Fight
that
the vending
you,
machine.
Yeah, burst fire with your skates. Just kind of tap the W instead of holding it down, and you get more of a, you can move left and right a little better. I think the movement is one of the things that they're working on as well.
Yeah, it went in. All right, I'm the master. I scored that. It was on stream. Everyone saw that.
Also, Cryptic C saying definitely on the list is a new account system. So no more people pretending to be other people in-game and those sorts of things. And so that'll also probably be a great way to keep track of... playing time and maybe even stats or something eventually, who knows, but an account system is definitely a welcome thing to be adding. Oh, and a big collision there.
And yeah, eventually this will be less laggy. And this is very.
Oh, that vending machine. I'm coming for you. I'm coming for you, vending machine. I'm leaping over people to beat the shit out of this vending machine. It's like Office Space.
I've got myself turned around. I don't remember what goal we're supposed to be going for.
Yeah, if you hold down the X button, you can kind of see the Robo Shakespeare.
This is the best way to just knock people off their feet. Put your head down on the ice and you just go right between your legs.
Oh, God. That was on stream. That was me. That was pretty great. I'll hold control up on my feet. All right. Oh, easy goal. No, I fucking don't know what I'm doing. New physics, why are you so... Ah.
I'm stabbing the cheesesteak machine repeatedly while I've got it up against the boards. So, somebody score quickly. You've got 2 seconds. 1 second. No.
We're both bad at this. Whoever me and this other guy cannot hit puck. Oh, Kripsky says they'll be adding sound soon.
Sound.
Potentially.
Ooh.
Well, hey, you know, I almost is all, you know, most of what I guess Winners and I do is comment on this game a lot. So the lack of sound doesn't really, I don't really even think about it, but yeah.
Will we get goal horns? We'll
just record hours of ourselves commentarying for like the NHL EA Sports games.
Oh, and everybody in the pile. To the pile.
And the pass goes to Ace Wolf. And he shoots the scores. Yeah, just sit in the booth and
let's get a good look at this
record every permutation
for the stream.
It's a thing of beauty.
I'm gonna wreck that show.
Deadly beauty.
You know, I think I'm gonna have an A3. That looks good.
Are you perusing the selections available from the vending machine?
Vending machine knocks it in his own net.
Oh, and there are bodies on the ice here.
Let the bodies
flow. Oh, I hit over. I lost the fight with that vending machine.
Robo versus vending machine, here we go.
Okay, so one goal has been scored. That's good.
Mm-hmm. Oh, somebody took me out.
That is quite the vending machine, though.
Yes, it is. It's coming for somebody there, and it's going to bolt it. Oh, he...
Going for somebody's life.
And
shit.
Now I'm going to jump on this son of a bitch. Oh, I missed him.
Someone has killed the vending machine.
Yeah, I'm like the Hanson brothers with this vending machine. You know, I'm totally overlooking the actual goal scoring that's supposed to be taking place. We're putting on the foil, coach.
Nope. I didn't jump over it. I just crashed into it. Trying to jump over the vending machine. I didn't jump high enough.
I'm like Tony Twist with this vending machine. I'm like Stu Grimson. Like Proby.
Oh, and we're done. Time to press zero again. But yeah, this is the prototype. Well, there's... When you play, you know, by yourself, there's some slightly different modes and whatnot. This dedicated server we have set up right now is just for the vending machine. But, which kind of is a sort of a sneak peek at a very simple hockey AI.
Yeah, it's a little mini game. You know, you try to score as many goals as you can before time runs out and the vending machine attacks you. I think Cryptic C said
scored
10 goals in one of these contests, quite impressive. So there you go, a dev that plays his own game and at a high skill level.
Just killed the vending machine.
And I'm guessing the spec mode will be essentially the same as it is in the 055 hockey that we've been using, which is fantastic. I say so every week, and I mean it, because that has really enhanced our casts of the game and our ability to really show you the beauty of hockey question marks. So I'm assuming that those tools will work pretty much how they worked before in the actual final builds of this version.
Oh, fucking hell.
Oh, you just got wrecked.
I ran right into the net.
Oh, he's talking about doing stuff for custom jerseys, kind of like the logo designer in A New Zero and Touring Car Legend. I love my little logo in Touring Car Legend. It kind of looks like a Cylon. I don't know. I did it by accident, and I'm like, oh, yeah, it's perfect.
Oh,
I'm hoping there. Can somebody ask if there'll be multiplayer for Touring Car Legends? I don't have. I'm not signed in over there.
That's a good question.
Because I want to Camaro the hell out of everybody.
Well, let's see here. I will. I'll type that in chat real quick.
Yes, that's another product from Cryptic Sea you can pick up as the Cryptic Sea EP. That's got all sorts of cool games on it. It's like one of those collections, like the good old days of little mini games that are all pretty cool. Skate or Don't is on there, which is kind of almost Excite Bike like skateboarding experience, and Touring Car Legend, which is probably my favorite on there. Enjoy that. And a couple other ones on there, too.
Indeed. I'm going to reset here at least one more time.
And that one is, I think, $3 and well worth it.
Oh, yeah. So let's pay what you want, minimum $3. So, you know, the true believers can maybe throw a little extra in. But, yeah, it's, I mean, $3. Come on. You got $3. Wait, you tell me you don't have $3, then why are you on the internet?
Yes, the minimum to join the internet is at least $3, I would think.
I mean, unless you're at a public library or something, but, you know. If you have your own computer and your own internet connection, you have $3. Just saying.
Yeah, I'm interested in what happens with New Zero, too. That's a fun game. And what's cool about these games is that everything that works with one is part of the development of others. And so, Sub Rosa, of course, we've had so much fun playing Sub Rosa, and that's on Steam Greenlight now. And I know he was talking about doing real kind of physics for player instead of animations or static models. You know, you got these real arms and legs, like we're seeing on the hockey here, that was work that was done in Sub Rosa that has been moved to hockey as well. So you know, all these games kind of end up being part of stuff. Up here. I'm getting this.
Oh, yeah.
Stuffs it in. He scores. Oh, and the wrong goal.
It's all right. We got 20 seconds. Get over the other side.
Wow, there's 5 tracks for Touring Car Legends?
Yeah.
Oh, snap. That's beautiful. I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure if that's a local or internet multiplayer. I asked. We'll see if he has an answer, but hopefully internet. I like internet multiplayer just because, well, I mean, we're casters, right?
Most of us live in remote areas where it's very difficult for us to meet up and play on the same computer. Yeah.
Oh,
now,
internet.
Skate or Don't,
right, okay,
that
yeah.
has a local multiplayer. And it's fun if you can get some other people to play. I think up to 4 people can play local multiplayer of Skate or Don't.
Oh, he says both internet and local. So you could even have 4 people on one PC connect to a server and play.
Oh, my God. Oh,
that
wow.
That would be pretty
beautiful.
Sweet.
Wow. Wow, so lots of interesting things happening in the Cryptic Sea development cycle right now. That's I want to thank him again for taking time to answer questions in the chat, and for making these games. They're a lot of fun, and I hope we helped in some way to with the development of these games, with promoting the alpha of this thing, because it's available for $8 right now. And for true believers only, he says, but it's a good way to support the developer and stuff. I mean, we have definitely had that much dollar-wise worth of entertainment from these games. I know personally I have. And just over the past year, everything that we've done with Friday Night Hockey. And also, we run the 4Stacks server for Sub Rosa. Mm-hmm. I'm really looking forward to the new version of that coming out, because that's like a whole different game. There's traffic that's there. The buildings are, you can get anywhere in the buildings and stuff. So I think sniping is going to come in. He's talking about expanding it from three teams to just as many teams as you want to make. And that could really get wild when you're talking about a whole city full of traffic and different teams fighting for discs or money, or having neither but having guns to shoot at each other.
Well, I mean, all you need, evidently, is guns.
Or yeah, love, we've seen depending that strategy on if you're the Beatles work pretty or not. Well. Yeah, we're going to do some esports with Sub Rosa, man. I definitely
New version of Sub Rosa comes out. Got tournament, whole nine yards. We're going to do it.
On a side note, we've been talking to a lot of people about esports this week. The first of the year, a lot of people are in full gear with their development of some of the... We're devoting ourselves to kind of looking at more off the beaten path kind of indie titles that are fun and that are deserving of attention, and that's kind of our focus here at IBN in the future, because it's either that or get into MOBAs or fucking card games now, Killinger. That appears to be where esports is going, and I will fight that tooth and nail however I can, and if it means fun little Unity games or whatever is out there, that we're even talking about making our own, that's coming up. We'll be able to tell you more about that. I don't want to give away too much just yet, but let's just say that there is hella esports coming up in 2014. We are talking to a lot of people, and we're very encouraged by what we're seeing and hearing from a lot of people in the gaming community. I think it's going to be a fun year, and last year kind of got, I don't know, there were times when esports was not the most encouraging thing to be part of. It's just with the way things were going. So it's like, well, when there's so much out there, and it's, let's focus on the good things instead of card games and MOBAs. Not that we won't have I talked to our star Hearthstone player today, and he is committed to carrying the Team Generator banner into battle. Well, that's a tough one. It's tough on the ears, fellas. Tough on the ears. But yes, yeah, so Hearthstone. That's the new thing.
Ooh. I don't know about the card games, but hey, you know.
And MOBAs are the devil. I mean, people have heard me say this many times. I mean, you don't have to take my word for it. Just look around.
Just go read the LOL or Dota forums. Shit. Figure it out pretty quick.
Oh, yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. But there are plenty of fun shooters and games of all kinds that I think are going to take up our time with a lot of fun here in the months to come. And even some of the big titles are worthy of attention, I think, as well. There's a few of those that we will be looking at. But, yeah, I think there are things that that could use a little shine, and we are having fun bringing that to you here on the channel as well.
And I have fallen over, and I'm having a hell of a time getting up. All right, there we go.
Yeah, I remember that commercial where that happened.
I have fallen, and I can't get up. Life alert, yes. That's a great question. Yes, will life alert be on all the players in the hockey with the new physics.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing how the player movement gets tweaked, and especially with where you can move sort of two directions at once and not have to kind of let up off of one to... Oh, man. Oh, and the vending machine goes down.
All right.
I'm gonna take a shot at it here, son of a bitch. Wind things down with a little beating up of the cheesesteak machine. And, yeah, I think that's probably going to do it for tonight, Killinger. We've been on an esports journey of hockey question mark epic proportions, and we are going to continue that into the weekend. Don't forget this Sunday, 2 days from now, on this channel, the greatest night in esports history, 2. One was not enough. This is even more epic, even bigger. This is Texas versus Massachusetts on a special edition of Sunday Night Hockey. Killinger is going to be here. I'm going to be here. We're going to have representatives from both states, and they are going to be battling it out either verbally or on the ice. That will be... they should have sent a poet. And they are. So we will be there this Sunday.
Indeed.
You can find out more about that at IBN Casting on Twitter. We'll keep you informed with all the latest things that we do. Be sure and follow the channel here on Twitch TV, and it will email you when epic games of this magnitude and other magnitudes are being played on the channel. And, of course, you can find us on Twitter, too. Killinger is at Dr. Is Sin, and I am at Winners of the One. You type the whole thing like a pimp named Slickback. And don't forget, too, we are on YouTube. That means we are officially esports. We are esports as fuck here at IBN. And you can find that by typing in IBN Casting into the YouTube search, and it will come up with our channel where we will have this archived up. If you're watching it, hello to you in the future. We hope the future is doing you a solid one way or the other, as we are here in the past bringing you this on VOD from YouTube. But if you're watching it live, we appreciate you too, as the millions of people who follow us and watch us. So we love you and we appreciate you. And we are looking forward to having a great 2014 with you as all these things take place. So we're just going to keep having a good time casting video games, playing video games. And we hope you'll join the ride with us, because it will be an entertaining one way or the other, Killinger. It always is, man.
Entertaining is a good word. Also, other good words for that might be interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, so...
As in, may you live in interesting times?
Yes. But overall, yeah, esports.
Esports as fuck. Yes, that should be our tagline here. And that's as good a place to end it, man. I'm Winners with the One. This is Dr. Killinger. We have been bringing you Friday Night Hockey, and we will see you Sunday night as Texas takes on Massachusetts and an epic battle for the age. I can't stop saying epic, because,
epic.
Yes, it is a four-letter word for awesome. And so, thanks, everybody. And from all of us here at the Independent Broadcast Network, good night, and we'll see you next time.